Wall Street is officially running for the exit. Well, we've shown you in the last couple of videos how Wall Street money flow has been exiting different sectors such as banking and the financial stocks. We actually shown you yesterday in the video the death cross on the chart of Bank of America. And what did you hear in the news today? Oh, they were talking about Bank of America crashing even lower. So who is next? Which stock is next? Leonardo, just stop showing us all these charts and doing all this stuff. Just tell us how low will this market go. Stop playing around, man. Well, okay. Actually, that's exactly what I was planning on doing in this video, guys. Okay. All right. I'm going to show you a few cool little things in this video. I'm going to answer some typical questions I've been receiving in the last, couple of days. Such as, should I buy gold right now? What should I be doing when the market is actually crashing? Not only this, guys, I'm going to reveal this new sector to you that has not crashed yet. And as you know, we've been preaching on this channel how it's important to short the stocks at the top. So this one sector is actually still at the top, and it is showing the signs of deterioration. And to us, it is presenting a great opportunity because it's about to drop like a rock. And that's not everything. In this video, I'm going to walk you through a trade, which I think a lot of people are closing their eyes on. Why? Well, because everyone is so focused on what? What's going on this week? If you're a trader, you should know. Amazon earnings, Google earnings, all that stuff is going on this week. So there is that one stock that just sort of kind of got left out, which I think presents an insane potential for trading options, put options, to profit from the inevitable downfall of this great, great stock. So here's what we've got. Check this out. Markets in the US had a chance to bounce Friday when all the Asian markets all of a sudden seemed like they found the bottom and they were rallying higher. And what we've identified on Friday is this. The reaction of the US markets was as such as we described in our 13 markets move formula. It was a market move too. Now, market move too actually will look to you, especially if you're a new trader, okay, especially if you don't use the charts, what it's going to look like to you when you open your computer in the morning and when you look at your phone, everything seems to be green on your screen. Why? Well, because initially the stock actually go higher. But the importance is whether they are able to maintain those high levels. And when we see this, this is a downtrend. And so initially the stocks, they pop, okay? And what we've been recommending in the last video, every time they do this, we recommended that you buy put options and profit on the downward spiral. So the point here is this, even though initially everything on your screen is gonna look green, ultimately the markets will come lower. That is actually a bearish sign, even though you may be looking at your screen and things may look bullish in the morning. And that's probably the point where you're going to be doubting where you should be buying puts or not. Well, look how consistent this pattern has been. Check this out. This is today, October 22nd. Same circumstances. Markets in the United States had a chance to bounce today, October 22nd, but we get another market move. And by the way, if you're a trader, if you're a data and you're curious to find out more about what these market moves are that help us determine the next market move, in other words, what's coming tomorrow. Tomorrow we actually predict a market move 3 where the markets are actually going to drop sharply lower in the morning and they're going to continue lower throughout the day. So if we're correct on that estimation, okay, check some of the information that we have listed below this video. We've recorded some courses on how you can learn the 13 markets move formula, on how you can take action before the market makes its next move against you. So getting back to this market move number 2, check this out. This is the action in the morning, right? So the Asian markets are bouncing even higher, building on top of the gains that they have established on Friday. So the initial reaction here in the United States markets is this. The markets are going higher. So again, you're sitting in front of your computer screen. You're looking, oh my God, the markets are turning around. Everything is green. There's no way, hell in the world, I am buying any puts today. But that is exactly what we recommended our alert subscribers do today. So Here's what happens, right? So for 10 minutes, the market goes higher. And then look at this. Look how quick the sell-off comes in, right? Very, very fast. Then they try to rebound, double top right here, go lower, try to rebound, go lower. Overall, the market ends up very close, just a few points off of the lows of the day. Now, why would that be? And I think there's a very simple explanation, right? With all the news of the Asian markets bouncing, nobody's really buying the story that bounce is actually real, that the bounce is substantial, that bounce actually could materialize further. So, and in order to show you exactly what I mean here, okay, I pulled up the chart, right? So maybe it's because tomorrow Asian markets will crash again. Maybe that's why the investors here in the United States are not reflecting it in United States markets going further higher. So we've talked a lot about this DEF cross, right? Oftentimes when you see this, the 50-day crossing, the 200-day moving average, it indicates trouble. And as you can see, so it indicated trouble for the Hong Kong Stock Exchange. Since the DEF cross took place, it literally lost thousands of points of the value. And so notice though, however, one little detail, right? Markets just never drop in one line. Of course, if you look at the shorter time frames, it may appear at certain times that it does, but generally speaking, right, it's trending lower. What we mean is going to bounce higher, and this is where you want to short it. This is where you want to buy puts, and then it's going to go lower. You want to collect some profits. It's going to bounce higher. You want to short again. And so this is what's been going on. So these are the last two big moves in this exchange in Hong Kong. And so you see these two white candles rallying higher. This is actually a 600 point going higher. Wow. And so why wouldn't that be good news? Well, clearly, again, yes, investors are not believing in this bounce. And maybe it's because at this point, this market is running at this huge level of resistance. They don't think it's going to break above. Or maybe if it does, you know, the same pattern will continue because this pattern has been highly repetitive. And notice, if you look on the daily chart, right, this is not exactly, but it's a version of what the Asian markets are doing, right? Market move number two, essentially, it's a downward spiral lower. Not a straight chart lower, but it's a bit of a slower trip, a lower to the downside. Now, ultimately, all of these moves, they're going to intensify, and at some point, they will hit the bottom. So you're going to see something like this. This move is going to continue, and then all of a sudden, whew, and that's why we've been talking about this 1,000-point drop in the Dow. And I think maybe somebody might have misunderstood me. We're not talking about a 1,000-point drop in S&P. We're talking about a 1,000-point drop in the Dow while we're going over examples of, you know, comparing this move lower and the intensity of it that compared to the markets, what the markets were doing back in February. And back in February, of course, went a couple of days where the markets dropped 600 points, you know, 1,000 points, 1,200, 1,300 points overnight. So, okay, enough. What exactly are you trying to say here? Just tell us the answer. How low are we going then on S&P 500 since we're talking about that? How low can we go? Okay, well, this is where we're at right now. Before I'm going to give you the answer how low we're going to go, here's the deal, okay? This is right here. I don't know about you, but I can only see in the last, 10 trading sessions, 11? 12, 13, basically, since October 1st, okay, I can only see one white candle. What's the problem with that? Well, there's nothing but selling is going on in the United States market. And again, generally speaking, when S&P 500 hits this orange line, right, look like right here, back in May, it hit this orange line. Look how quickly it bounced and how fast and how high it went. Well, we're not seeing any action like this. What this tells us, even at these lower levels in S&P 500, the investors are not interested in buying the stocks. So what they're really saying this time, they're not buying the dip. That's the simplest translation I can come up with. Investors are not buying the dip. We've been sitting around this 200-day moving average, which generally serves as a strong support of which the stocks could go higher. Generally speaking, the investors will come in and they like to use these levels to accumulate positions in various stocks. However, we're not seeing that they're doing it this time because, just as you heard, all the banking stocks, okay, what are they doing today? They're not buying them. They're saying to buy them, but they're doing exactly the opposite. They're getting rid of them, okay? And we're noticing that just not just with the banking sector, but with multiple sectors that I pointed out in the last couple of previous videos, okay? So we're not going to go through pretty much every bearish thing on this chart, but there's multiple cases of divergences. As a matter of fact, we're able to point this move before it actually happened right here. And so now we're seeing the move is going to come much, much lower. In order to tell you how much lower, we're going to show you right here, S&P 2323. Now, that's quite a substantial drop, which will put us on the weekly chart all the way back at this orange moving average line right here, which represents substantially a longer amount of time. As you can see, the data here on S&P would be going almost 2+ years. Okay, so what do we see as far as this longer time chart? Well, we're seeing divergence on the other side. We're seeing the double top formation. We're seeing some bearish candle formation here. So now what makes us think that the magnitude of the move is going to be so huge? What makes us think that, for example, we're not going to stop at 2,700 or 2,600? What makes us think that we're going to go all the way to 2323? And by the way, you're probably thinking, well, how long is this going to take? I mean, Leonardo, what are you talking, a couple of years? No, I'm saying couple of weeks, okay? Couple of weeks. Today is October 22nd, so maybe by Halloween, the markets are going to get real, real scared, okay? So check this out. Here's the thought process on this, okay? Oh, some of you are going to say, okay, if you really believe it's going to crash to 2323, should we buy gold? And the simple answer to that is not yet. Not yet. You're going to say, what do you mean? You're saying the market is going to crash. Shouldn't we be buying gold? Well, again, the answer is not yet. Look at the chart of the US dollar. You're going to say, what does US dollar have to do with gold? Well, generally speaking, when dollar is strong, you're not going to get a rally in gold. It's been in the long uptrend for quite some time. And as you can see, this is not a death cross. This is actually a bullish crossover, which is exactly the opposite of the bearish crossover. So the bullish crossover is when the blue line will cross the orange line. Okay. So here's where the dollar index is at 575, which is very, very strong. Okay. And it creates a lot of issues. And I'll give you a clue what sort of issues it creates. But just remember this. I'm not going to go into a lot of details here that impact gold. But this is definitely one you should be paying attention to. So until the dollar gets actually weaker, it doesn't mean that gold is going to drop. Gold is trading, and we're definitely seeing some investors coming in, and they're starting to buy gold. Okay, we're not basically saying that gold is not going to go substantially higher from here until the dollar is going to start dropping. Now, if the dollar gets maybe to these areas right here, 92, 90, which is quite a bit lower from where it's trading right now, right, then we're going to see a substantial move in gold. But as long as the dollar maintains this strong uptrend, okay, it's not yet the time to buy gold, or definitely not establish any huge positions. Okay, so in the last two videos, we described the case for deflation. Actually, we showed you multiple charts of how Wall Street was running for exit in financial, in banking sectors. And yes, we're talking about Bank of America and JP Morgan. And I know, I saw it on the news today. I was like, man, I can't believe they're talking about Bank of America. We just showed the death cross on that thing yesterday, and here they are, a day behind us. All right, so out of sales. You know, they're running for exit and out of sales. They've been running for exit in home builders, transports, industrials, and so on. So the question is this. Look at all these sectors selling off. The answer is very simple, right? If you're a hardcore bull listening to this, thinking, man, this dude, I can't even understand how the things he's saying, you know, what's up with his accent and all that stuff, and you know, all these things that you're thinking right now that I'm wrong. I get it. That's fine. So a lot of people thought I was wrong when I told them to short Bitcoin was 18,000. But that's cool. I know it was hard to understand at that point, but you know what's even crazier? I made another video and I posted and told people to sell Bitcoin at 11,000, and they were still sending me a bunch of nasty comments, right? So, and then I told them to sell it again at 9,000. And so those that listened made money. So hopefully, if you are maybe one of those people, that you will maybe actually listen this time, because all I'm trying to do is to help you. I'm trying to help you profit. I'm trying to help you get out of stocks before it's too late to get out of stocks. But a lot of people can help you do that. What I can really help you do, and what we do here at MarketCrash.Money Trading Options, is we show you strategies on how you can profit when stocks drop through utilizing put options. So if you'd like to learn more about that, I'm actually going to walk you through a trade at the end of this video. So here's the deal. What's the big deal? All these sectors are selling off. Well, it brings us to the main question. What is the probability of the markets going higher with so many sectors dropping faster than Turkish lira? Well, the probability to us is zero. Now, to make the matters even more probable on the fact that the markets are not going to go higher, another day, another sector goes down. And actually, pay attention to this one, because this one, it's quite interesting. And here's why. This is one sector that's been holding up the best out of all sectors in the last 4 months. Now, finally today, it gave in, and we think it will go much lower. Again, you want to short stocks. You want to start shorting stocks when they're pretty much at the top or close to the top to make the best returns. So a lot of sectors have already come down substantially. So this sector just beginning the drop. What do you think it is? Hey, take a wild guess. It's the healthcare stocks. Even stocks like Aetna, right? And what makes us believe so? Well, because we study the charts. If you want to learn more about the charts, click the links below this video. Check out some of the chart courses that we've got recorded, especially the Charts and Patterns Divergence course. Like here, it's the same thing that made us determine that when everybody was screaming buy, buy, buy Amazon at $2,050, we were noticed same observations, and we said, hell no, you want to short Amazon. And shortly after that, it drops $120 within 48 hours. And you know what trades today? So we made that call when Amazon was at 2050. Today, Amazon is around 1750, 1760. Actually, it's in the 1700s, period. So a few cases of divergences. I'm not going to bore you to death going over them, but there's just a ton of things that are very bearish on this chart. And as you can see, compared to a lot of banking stocks that have charts that already crossed over and they're in a 50% of their highs and so on, this one is just beginning to drop, and we think it could materialize all the way to this 185 range right there. Okay, so big sell-off coming. Humana has been the financial institution's all-time favorite. Look at this nice, smooth uptrend all the way from May till now. But look at this multi-top formation and this huge divergence with the RSI. Wow, this thing is going to tank. Okay, Molina Healthcare, look at this one. Wow, look at this huge divergence that are on our side. Multi-top formation, crossover in the MACD. Guys, there's like 10 different bearish things here. So, and this one is just beginning to drop, an easy 30% drop to around $102 in not so distant future. Okay, so can you imagine what will happen if FANG stocks begin to sell off as well? So one of the most typical questions we've been getting the last 48 hours is this. You know, what do the technology stocks have to do with the banking stocks selling off and all of that stuff? And so in the prior two videos, we made the case that we're heading into deflationary environment. So the point number one here is stocks, growth stocks, such as Amazon and Google and BKG and Facebook, they don't do very well. They don't perform very well in the slowing growth type environment. After all, they're growth stocks, right? So when growth is slowing, they're not going to do as well. And number two, point number two is even more important. Okay, they are the most crowded stocks. And when institutional investors tomorrow sprint for the exit, these stocks will drop faster than anything else in this market because everybody will be unloading them at the same time. Now, however, as early as stated, Amazon and Google, they're announcing earnings. And so their options are insanely expensive right now, and they will remain expensive until Thursday evening after they announce earnings. After the options take a hit, after the earnings announcement Friday will give you the green light to go ahead and trade these things. But what do you do in the meantime when the market continues the crash that it started on October 19th? It continued the crash today, October 22nd. It's going to continue the crash tomorrow, October the 23rd. So what do you do in the meantime? So I'm going to give you one trade that we think is going to materialize, and it's going to be the all forgotten BKNG trade. And here I have a chart of Expedia. You're going to be like, why are you showing us Expedia? You're telling us about BKNG trade. Well, guys, this is one of those correlation type trades. And Expedia is actually going to be announcing earnings this Thursday after hours. Now, here's a little secret. Generally speaking, when Expedia goes higher, BKNG or Priceline goes higher as well. Now, we don't like to trade Expedia because we don't like to trade stocks with low DTR, what we call daily traveling range or a daily trading range. So generally, we like to trade higher priced stocks. Because we trade options, it allows us to do that really inexpensively. If you're watching this video and you're trying to figure out, well, I don't have a $100,000 account. I mean, I only got a few thousand dollars to trade options in my account. Can I do the same strategy? Yes. As a matter of fact, if your account is not huge, options allow you to be a bigger player in the world of trading without utilizing a ton of capital. And being able to trade stocks like the big heavy hitter institutional players that trade Amazon millions of shares a day, that trade Facebook millions of shares a day, that trade all these high-priced stocks like Google and Priceline, okay? If you'd like to learn more about that, right, just click the links below, get more information below this video, okay? For the purpose of this trade, let me walk you through this, okay? So here's Expedia. We're observing a multi-top formation, also resembles a head and shoulder in a little bit, okay? But what do you guys see this? Remember in the last video, we spent quite a bit of time showing you that when this death cross takes place, and it looks like the blue line is just super close, and it's probably going to cross this orange line right after the earnings are going to be announced on Thursday night. So check it out. Check out, take a look at this chart on Friday or Monday. It should probably cross this orange line by that point or sometime next week. The importance of that is this. Basically, we think Expedia is going to drop after earnings. And what makes us believe that it's going to drop after earnings, we have been observing a very incredibly bearish activity in Expedia in terms of amount of put options that institutional investors have been purchasing different strike prices, $120, $110, $100 strike prices, going anywhere from a month out all the way to 3 to 6 months ahead in the future. So I think we're getting the consistent reading here on the fact that the chart looks extremely bearish, and we're also putting that together with institutional put activity in this name. And by piecing the action together, we're basically saying that no matter what the earnings report is going to say, Expedia is going to drop Thursday night. And if Expedia drops Thursday night, then Priceline is going to drop by a much higher amount. Generally speaking, if Expedia was to drop, let's say, from 118 all the way to 110 or maybe 105, we can expect a move in Priceline to the extent of maybe 50 bucks. Here's the thought behind the trade. I've got the dollar chart here again, okay, and I'm going to give you another little secret. The secret is this. Priceline does most of its earnings outside of the U.S. And so when it announces earnings, it has to convert everything from foreign currencies into dollars. And so that actually is a very negative thing. So the higher the dollar goes, the lower the earnings per share Priceline is going to be able to record in dollars. So the rise in dollar is another sort of bearish thing that Priceline's got going for it. And that's another piece of information that we're using to calculate this trade. So with that being said, okay, we see BKNG at $1,640. When in the next 2 weeks, if we're correct in our calculation on the Expedia situation, observing the bearish put option activity, observing the bearish chart, I don't think people are really going to care whether the earnings are good or bad. If Expedia falls, BKNG is going to fall. Now, before, we're recording this on October 22nd, right? So basically, until Expedia announces earnings, BKNG was trading today at 1,840, 1,850. It closed at 1,827. We think it actually come down to about $1,800 in the next few days. So maybe before Expedia actually announces earnings on Thursday, BKNG could be trading in the range of $1,780 to $1,790. Then, as you can see, if another $50 drop going to come down from that, it's actually going to be able to fall, Priceline that is going to be able to fall below this recent low level that was set just a few days ago of $1,750. So it will literally put it at a level of about $1,730, $1,740. As you can see, there's not a whole lot going on here as far as the level of support. We can easily see the stock go all the way to about $1,600. The low that was established today, I remember it, I was trading the stock that day, was $1,640. So that's how we're estimating this. I think not only is it going to break for this level right here, but it's also going to touch this level here, which is $1,640. So that's how we're coming up with this calculation. And so we're expecting the biggest part of the move to come on Thursday night. So when you're going to open your screens on Friday, we're expecting the Priceline stock to trade significantly lower from where it's trading today. Now, how would you literally put this trade together? All you got to do is just do a simple directional trade. You don't have to worry about a thing, just because BKNG, unlike Amazon or Google, it is not announcing earnings today. So all you have to do is buy 1,800, 1,810, or 1,820 puts. And you can buy this week or next week expiration. If it makes you feel more cozy and comfortable, buy them a month ahead and expect the further drop. And here we've got the daily chart that looks extremely bearish, right? Remember the death cross, here it is. Some black candle action, some black reversal candles right here. You got some bearish crossovers. You got, look, there's not one bullish thing right here on this chart. So if we've gotten this trade calculated correctly, guys, by analyzing and studying the charts, this should be a nice little trade. I hope our thought process, helping somebody out there, how we find some of these trades. If you'd like to learn more, hey, check this out below. We got plenty of links with some courses that are recorded that can help you become a better trader. Now remember this, we don't get every trade right, okay? But we sure get a lot more right than we get wrong. So thanks for tuning in today, watching the video. I hope you learned something. The market's about to get super excited. So guys, no matter how this trading year has gone for you so far, I promise you, if you learn the divergences, if you learn some of our trading materials, this year could be a highly profitable year for you, even though there's only a couple of months left. So if you're curious to know the top three chart patterns that we use for certain stocks, if you're curious to learn about divergences, how do we actually figure out how the moves happen before they actually take place? Okay, definitely get access to this information, learn more so you can be better, so you can be more consistent, so you can have more clarity when you're trading. Take action now and make this year your best trading year ever. I'll catch you in the next video.